I think sometimes the if they've got spare rounds, it can give that false sense of security that, oh, I can shoot faster. But should you shoot faster if you haven't trained to shoot faster? You only if you know that you can shoot faster, get the targets down, should you try and do it. Otherwise, stick to your routine.
Routines are always great. And then the lack of air up here. Persian Magnussen, Uberg, that's Hannah Uberg, and then her younger sister, Elvira. Great team from Sweden. And a change in running order here and in the personalities in the German team. Voigt Schneider, Hettich Waltz, and Kebinger, the least experienced World Cup racer for Germany, taking the anchor leg. That's an interesting one. Further down, Estonia. They've performed. I like the way they've performed this season. They're ranked ninth at the moment. And further back, Latvia, with the experienced team, I was going to say. A slightly inexperienced team with the Bulina twins in the lineup. And I hope it goes well for the Latvian team today. Japan are just ahead of them, and Romania ranked number 18. French team looking more confident this weekend. Sixth in Ruhpolding. That was a huge surprise. Italy, can they win here? I think this team is as good as we've had. New athlete coming in, Okuntalo, the 21-year-old. She's from this valley. She knows these tracks well. She knows the range well. I don't think that's a setback that she's included in this race today. Aita Gasparin and Elisa Gasparin, they were rested yesterday, and I like the way that Sandra Flunger has rested them. They haven't been shooting well, Scott. I feel quite good for them today.
I'm a little bit nervous for the Swiss team, I have to admit. I think that the standard is not as high as it could be, but we'll see. We'll see how that unfolds.
We'll see. Well, that was the Norwegian team. Finn Steinweg, Ida Lien, Marta Osbu-Reusland, and Tandervold taking the anchor. Here's the German team. Vanessa Voigt, she's quite right to be looking pretty confident. 29th, in fact, 29th and 25th here. Fifth last week, so she hasn't adjusted to the altitude yet. Lynn Persson, safe biathlete, I think, going first. Hopefully they will not have any difficulties there in leg one. Then Anna Magnussen, Hannah Uberg, and Elvira Uberg. Brorson, who let them down last week. Interestingly, she was on the penalty loop. Did let the team down. They handed over in 15th place after her first leg. She's not included today.
That's a shame, because she's always been very stable for the Swedish team, and I think that form will return. It's just a matter of time. When will it return? Because she was part of the Olympic team that won the gold medal in Pyeongchang.
Yes, and it's the name of the game. If you perform badly at this level, you're dropped down. Let's show your worth the next time, and we may include you. So about to get underway, nervously ready to pounce as soon as the starter's gun has fired. 1 minute to the start, I think that's what Borut said. There he is, just informing the athletes. So all these spectators, Scott, right on their right shoulder as they come in to shoot. It's going to be interesting how that affects especially Italy and Germany, the most fans from those two countries.
You'll certainly hear a lot of cheering for the German team in particular.
So the women's relay, the last day of racing here in Antols, about to get underway. Anxious moments, Finn Steinweg just anxiously looking down this 200 metres straight before they go into the forest, under starter's orders now. Lynn Persson just having a look at her watch. Rebecca Pasla for Italy. She's only 21. It's a big moment in her career. And off they go. 20 teams. It'll soon probably work its way into two files, two separate rows of athletes. And who is, that's Norway, I think, taking the initiative early and controlling the pace. So Ragnhild Fem Steinvik, the 27-year-old, leading the way out of the stadium.
And I think that her performance this season has been, by Norwegian standards, quite low, with a lot of positioning lower than 20th in the World Cup overall results. So I think that she's up against it to contend with the likes of Lynn Persson today.
And it does worry me. Finn Steinweg, 46th, 3 days ago, 44th yesterday. But notably, she missed one, then the perfect five, then she missed another one. and she only hit one out of five the last time in yesterday. That will be in the back of her mind.
Yeah, and I think there's going to be a lot of work for Roysland and Tandrevold to almost recover what could turn out to be a little bit of a setback in the first two legs, potentially. Hopefully not much. Sometimes some of the lower performing biathletes are able to stay with the leaders in mass starts because either the first lap, like you're seeing right now, is particularly slow, or because you're able to get in behind somebody on their heels and just tuck in and chase.
It's interesting, isn't it? Because it is only 2 kilometres, trying to go round on the inside there but not succeeding. I think that's Ukraine. Apologies, can't see the number right now. But yes, it is much easier to stay, survive. Certainly this pace isn't fearsome at the moment, but it will pick up as the race goes on.
If I was one of the faster biathletes, my goal would actually be to bring the pace up to prevent teams that otherwise wouldn't keep with the pace from potentially featuring or getting a little bit too much hope later on in the race when their more powerful athletes are on the start line.
Yes, that was Anna Krivonos from Ukraine, desperately trying to find her way around on the right side, then the left side. But to be honest, when there's 18 athletes ahead of you, or 20 athletes ahead, it's difficult to get through the pack. What's your feeling on Tandrevold? So Tandrevold, in the first race, she finished 52nd, and in the second race, 38th. I mean, way off form in terms of those positions that we've seen recently. Recent times, she's been top 10 regular. What's your thinking there? Would you have put her last leg?
Well, she's so reliable in the shooting, with 96 in prone and stand 81%. However, that 81% was yesterday 88%. She missed 4 in the sprint in the stand, and she had pretty poor with 3 mistakes in the stand yesterday in the pursuit. So a lot of mistakes and very uncharacteristic. I think the Norwegian team has said, we know your standard. You've done it all season. Whatever this blip is now, we're not going to affirm that lack of confidence or lack of ability by not putting you last, because we know you're good enough.
I like your thinking. Obviously, it's the thinking from the Norwegian camp. I feel a bit nervous that, when you only hit 1 out of 5 3 days ago, didn't go great yesterday. She missed 2 and then 1 standing. But you're right. Don't make it comfortable. Put them straight in at the deep end. So we'll see. I did think that Tandrevold in zeroing, there's a fall. Is that the French team? No, I don't think that was the French team on the inside. So just getting wedged there on the inside.
Чате,
and that's a loss of some 10 seconds.
Гонку,
speed carried over the rise of the big high point on the course.
Ну, потому что понятно, что Норвегия победит, да? And as a consequence, lots of athletes jostling for position. Сегодня у Германии нету Денис Херман, и будет ему очень трудно. В сборной Австрии тоже нету Лизы Терезехаузер. Ну и у Словении нету Лампич. Ну это...
But a real blip in her results as she came here. She shot 0-2 in the sprint race, finishing 9th. 18th yesterday,
не так важно. Зато у Швеции сегодня не едет Анна Магнуссон. А, нет, едет Анна Магнуссон на втором этапе. И едет Эльвира Оберг на четвертом. Как и Жюли Симон у Франции сегодня стартует. Последний старт у женщин перед чемпионатом мира, который начнется 8 февраля. Очень интересная гонка, на самом деле.
Her teammate, there is Lou Jean-Mano, is really punching this pace coming in. She's trying to hurt the rest. She's certainly stretching those 19 teams behind her, really stretching them out. I hope she hasn't come in too fast.
В голосовании в чате выигрывает Франция с огромным отрывом. Зрители считают, что Франция сегодня победит. Ну, у Франции сегодня действительно сильный состав.
Five shots in the magazines and 3 hand-fed spares should any of the 5 targets remain. Sweden missing, the very reliable Lynn Persson missing the first shot.
Austria, 5 из 5.
Of Austria, as does
А Лин Персон мажет. Фим Штенлик тоже. Один промах. Кто ж долг? У Австрии будет первая.
Sorry, excuse me, Rebecca Passler for Italy. Yes, Passler take the first leg. Jean Monod was perfect as well. Scott, absolutely 5 out of 5. She punched the pace coming in. Slovenia clear, America clear as well. And Estonia, well, I had some good feelings there for Estonia, but Ermits just struggling there. And Latvia as well with two rounds left.
Estonia, два штрафных круга.
Estonia on the penalty loop, two times around the penalty loop. What a horrible start.
Пять промахов.
The Estonian team. Stuage, she's fired now 35 shots at this venue. She hasn't missed one target. And the Austrian team out first, just ahead of Germany in second place. And France with that beautiful 5 out of 5. There she is, Jean Monod, 5 out of 5. And exiting in third place.
And Dunja Zaduk of Austria taking out in first position currently, leading the way. Great shooting.
Well, very interesting. Still in the penalty loop, actually. Estonia, all of the other teams have actually avoided the penalty loop.
And Persson была шестая.
Is really of a high
уже
standard.
Обогнала чешку.
Nine teams not even requiring one spare
round. Отыгрывает позиции, перемнула Олен Персон.
For many of the teams getting the targets down.
Fem Steinovic there making a move, trying to get out the outside of the track where it was a little congested earlier, a bit more space. Trying to close the gap on the leader. She does not want that to open too much. Equally, she does not want to burn herself out too much. Else she'll
Итальянку тоже обгоняют.
Struggling to contain herself on
Ребекку
the shooting
range.
Soon to come.
Yes, I think,
сегодня у Италии Вирер стартует на втором этапе, а Витоци на четвертом. Снова поменялись девушки.
And they really have put a lot of faith in the youngster, the least experienced athlete. I often say the least experienced going first and last for me keep them safer in positions 2 and 3, but she's absolutely shining today.
Yeah, big pressure, and I was really surprised with the German team today opting to put Hannah Kebinger in the final position, because she's just come from IBU Cup. She's done 2 races on the World Cup, and yes, she's hit 100% in the prone, but she's also skiing around about 23, averaging 23 ski speed. Somebody with that ski speed trying to keep up with the top athletes is going to be pushed, going to be pressured, and she's going to really hope that that she'll be able to maintain that standard of shooting when she's under that much pressure.
So out on the track, the pace is now really at full pace, at absolute open end full pace. And it really is stretching out the field. So 5 at the front, slight separation. Jean Monod really pushing hard up to the high point of the whole course. Quite a easy part of the course coming up. You turn right round here. We saw an athlete getting wedged into the advertising boards there on the right side. But the traffic is pretty much open up this climb now. Fem Steinvik. Oh, she looks labored. She's tired. So many World Cup races. And it's not just the legs, is it, Scott? It's the mental impact all the time, getting yourself up on almost a daily basis to push as hard as you can once again.
Yeah, and when she came out of the shooting range, she was 15 seconds behind. Ванесса Уайт
обогнала Олен Персон в повороте. Очень красиво.
So now she's only 12 seconds behind, but the lead has changed, so although she may have caught up a few seconds, she's actually lost time on who the current leaders are.
Certainly looks that way. The pace really at the front from Jean Monod is absolutely hurting everybody. She's hoping she's hurting less. Voigt, interestingly, staying with the pace, who I felt was a little off form in the two races, the two outings up here at altitude in Antholz.
And Lynn Persson, she's actually closed the gap down on Jean Monod, but not managed to get it all the way. And I think that's tactical on Jean Monod's part. She has decided, hey, the leaders are catching up. They've stressed to get here. So I'm going to make him hurt a little bit more, make him earn the drafting experience of getting behind me.
Well, it's the stand shoot coming up now. So difficult here in terms of stabilizing the rifle. There's no wind today, so that certainly makes the task a lot easier. But this pace coming in, yes, they've rested, dropping down off the high point in the field, but really punching the pace up into the range now.
Vanessa Voigt, 20 out of 20 at the Olympic Games.
Сегодня снова сборная Норвегии. But that was just a few days after a disappointing penalty loop and the single mixed relay at the Olympic Games. Поможет ли это им победить? Посмотрим.
Now, can we hear? We can. The breathing, you're just desperately trying to get some recovery, stability into your body. So lining up the rifle, Jean Monod probably firing the first shot. And it's a hit, followed closely by Lynn Persch, and Lynn's already on two, Jean Monod on three. They're almost firing one for one here, and they're all hitting.
Nice, Lynn Persch missed for France.
Jean Monod taking a little risk there, possibly, but she's got it down now, so she's safe. Stuart has now hit 40 out of 40 at this venue. Fabulous shooting from Stuart.
And also great shooting there
from Steinweg, тоже мажет.
Coming out in second position.
What a race! There's, I mean, it's aggressive on the track, it's aggressive
Закрывает.
On the range, and most of the targets going
Немка.
Down, but Vanessa Voigt having to take two spare rounds there, Scott, so she
really
was gasping. That pace was
закрывает,
and eventually she got her breathing under control.
I wouldn't be surprised if this is the highest standard of shooting that we've had all season. There's very few spare dippers being used, so yeah, great all round. We're seeing a few more misses now, Slovakia. We've got some misses, that's two. And Romania, we're going to need to get the next three with all the dippers, otherwise she will be on the penalty loop.
Romania, two rounds left, two spare bullets left, two targets standing. It's edgy when you get to that stage. And they're taking a huge amount of time, and sadly for Romania, it's on the penalty loop at least once. So Team 10 just exiting now.
And also penalty loop for Laura Hristova. Of Bulgaria, so that's unfortunate.
Lynn Persson, I thought this was great. She really was hurting coming into the range. Didn't mess about, straight into the first short release. Well, in fact, just in behind Jean Monod. And the fans are delighted. So Jean Monod just a little edgy there, running out of air, the shot missing, delayed timing, so almost holding her breath for a little too long, and missing high right. She got it down with the first of the spare rounds.
Jean Monod, которая отыграла
позицию. That's why she's on the
Австрийка не тянет.
She's a very safe starter.
6 секунд уже.
Now is just how much can I open the gap over the likes of Germany?
Есть Ванесса Войт, у которой было 22 секунды отставания. Уже 17.
But she'll also be working together with Rebecca Pastler to open up as much a gap as possible. She is faster than both of them and Dunja Zuduk, so she's really got to, I think, open up a 5 to 10 second gap on this last leg.
She's going to try. Jean Monod is actually pulling back already. Jean Monod left just under 5 seconds behind. We can see now she's on the tails of the skis of Lynn Persson. Very impressed with Pastler.
It's one of the times in a relay race where the leaders can now work together to open up a gap against the bigger nations behind. So it's not necessarily you having to, oh, I'm going to go slow and just stay on your heels and beat you in a sprint finish. That doesn't advantage the rest of the team. So just going past, helping each other out when necessary and when possible to get as fast a lap as possible.
Let's have a look at the glide. Jean Monod free skating, and you can see the benefits there. Just passing the right shoulder of Lynn Persson for the first time. Lynn Persson will desperately try to stay with this burning pace. And Jean Monod, that was very clever, using that momentum to get free energy. Dance our way up there in skate one.
And look at the beautiful France, skate there from Jean Monod. And not as effective as Lynn Persson skate one. I think that, I mean, impressive. The skate two was impressive, but perhaps not the optimal strategy for this hill.
So the first of the athletes now working their way to the stadium. And athlete number two about to, get underway. Anna Magnusson, safe. Again, safe with the rifle. There she is, just putting her skis on the
Anna
right
Magnusson.
Side there.
Oh, shit,
Anna Magnusson for Sweden. Sophia Schneider for Germany, just getting ready. And this is a wonderful start for the Italian team.
У Италии. Ну, посмотрим, сейчас отметка 5,7 километров.
a really impressive performance, and one that I hope is going to give her a lot of confidence for the World Championships in Oberhof in 2 weeks' time.
Just thinking, I'm looking down through the history of the relay here at this venue, at this location, and yeah, Italy in the women's field, they've done it in the men's team a number of times, podiumed and won the race. That's not the case for the women, so this, I'm feeling that it's the beginnings of the Olympic team for 3 years' time, and already the momentum...
Ну, смотрите, как бы быстро Жан-Мано не ехала, норвежка и немка догоняют ее. По 4 секунды отыгрывают за километр.
Лиса Витоци, who was particularly successful in 2019-20, she's now back in business, showing the world that she's capable of being atop the podium.
And that's after some tough times last year.
Очень сильно оторвалась от Лин Персон.
I think she's bought herself 100% the starter for the World Championships, and that relay will be on Saturday, the 18th of February. So Jomano looking the best I think we've seen her all.
С одним запасным закончила француженка.
And opening up something like what, 5-6 seconds, and that's a pretty handy lead for Chevalier
Boucher.
So over to Chevalier Boucher. She's finished 15th and 13th here over the last 4 days. And Sweden, Lynn Persson tried to stay with it. She couldn't quite survive. It's dropped to 8.2 now. And Italy only 10 seconds behind. I think they will be happy with that start from Rebecca Passler. Germany and Norway side by side. And just let's have a look. So Germany 15.9, Norway 16.3 behind.
Германия, София Шнайдер.
Also from the Czech Republic and from Austria, who are still well and truly within touching distance of the lead.
That's a wonderful start. Stuic is renowned. Чехи, Джессика Истлова, которая вчера отсутствовала, не стартовала.
23 seconds on this last 2 kilometers, but it's a great start for Austria. 10 coming in now. It's Suvi Minkinen for Finland. A decent start, but look at the time deficit now. Coming up to the minute already. So an amazingly aggressive start there for France. Normally we have at least 14 teams within a minute after the first leg athletes. Surprised at Slovakia. Thought it might have started a little better for Team 12 there.
Промазывала 4 раза, по 2 на каждом рубеже, 4 запасных она потратила.
I actually think it might have been Switzerland who went down, but that isn't going to have the impact that we're seeing here with that time deficit. I just think that the form is not quite there.
Швейцария на 11-й строчке с одним промахом всего. Сегодня не в форме, видимо, Гаспарин.
I just don't think they're going to be able to prop her up sufficiently by leg 4.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. Yes, Heike Gross, I think in this, the relay, she's a lot safer. Her shooting sometimes is edgy, but with 3 spare rounds, she does seem to calm down and manage the pressure much better.
Посмотрим, как у Швейцарии старшая сестра сейчас справится, Элиза Гаспарин на втором этапе.
She's 32-year-old now. She was disappointed yesterday. She started first in the pursuit competition. She led most of the way, but in the end finished 7th.
Норвегии Ида Лиен сегодня едет.
And they're chasing this lady for France, Chevalier Boucher, vastly experienced. Often comes to her highest level, or she seems to raise her game at major championships, and she'll be very much looking forward to the 8th of February, the first race at the World Championships.
I'm interested in Ida Lien of Norway. She didn't
race. Маркета Давыдова на 3-м этапе поедет у сборной Чехии.
Now taking the second leg for the Norwegian team. That is meaning that
пока чешки не промахивались. На 1-м этапе по нулям. Как и у сборной Австрии и Италии.
I'm really surprised that Norway and Ida Lien has pulled back nearly 2 seconds on the burning pace at the front from Chevalier Boucher. For me, that rings alarm bells. It's an incredibly aggressive start. Her expected ski space speed actually today was a lot less than what she's achieving now. So this is the moment you can get your breath back and actually rest the legs, because it's a fairly straight run out. Then you're straight back into this climb before the tunnel on the bridge into the stadium.
It's a good recovery, but also you're getting elevated by the crowd who are cheering you along. This entire, it's almost like a love heart shaped field.
Без удивительного, это сборная Канады с 14-й строчки сейчас поднимается. На шестую строчку. Обгоняет она Анну Гандлер.
But all the time you're thinking, right, I have to come in now, control myself, switch off from this, the aggression of cross-country skiing, into a precision shooter.
Gandler of Austria, she again, when some of the athletes who are not quite up there in terms of ski speed, although Gandler is very fast, having to stay with that top level pace, it changes the routine. So what's most interesting for me, what they come to is how do they adapt? Do they compensate for that extra challenge that they've been forced to go through on the track? Take it a little bit slower, few extra breaths. How does it change?
Interesting. I thought Jean-Paul, he's on the scope of the French team. Was he trying to warm his feet up? He was doing a little dance. Now he'll be on the scope as Chevalier Boucher builds her position. She's got the fastest shooter in the world and most often the most accurate to her left shoulder. She certainly is fully aware that four teams are alongside her right now. First shot down for France. And the second. Dorothy Avira taking much longer today, Scott, than
Промахивается,
but she will shoot fast. Vera has missed
struggling a little. That's why Magnussen
missing two out of it. And Dorothy Avira, what
Сколько
is going
on?
All the while they're letting
француженка заканчивает, и канадка Мозер тоже уходит, второй будет. Посмотрим, как Иделиен сейчас справится. У нее всего три запасных. Она сейчас не заметила руку, как будто подняла. Дорте Вир отстрелялась. Уходит, будет пятый. А норвежка идет на штрафной круг, вот так вот. Пока не идет это у Норвегии. Ждем третьего этапа.
Здесь
Лиза Гаспарин. 31 год.
The pace really has been burning out there. And again, has the wind changed the flags? Well, they are sort of changeable. So maybe it's the wind flags partly that are making this first time in for the second leg athlete so difficult.
We definitely saw at the beginning of the race a
quite initial pace.
And that meant that there wasn't as much more was in the athlete's control. They were able to take their own pace and be smart about it.
When you're the second, Мария Дер и Украины Юлия Джима на втором этапе уходит, как и молодая словенка Лена Репинч.
Ременова and her twin sister takes the anchor leg, and with missing that many targets, I hope she can make it. Strange team. You've got the Fialkova sisters and the Remenova twins in the Slovak team. It's not going well today. Wow, so back out in the forest, and it's a really comfortable lead for Team France. And we must big up Nadia Moser and the Canadian team. From nowhere, Moser, it was a good start. They really did have a comfortable start into the second leg athlete. Emma Lunder putting in a good leg.
Да, держит канадка. Темп.
Holding the pace here.
Догоняет ее София Шнайдер.
Canada in second place.
Sophie Schneider in third there, tucking in behind Nadia Moser of Canada at the moment. And Austria still managing to...
Анна Гандлер также четвертая.
She's got Dorothy Vera on her heels, which I imagine is going to be a little bit nerve-wracking, but get in behind her and she'll pull you along comfortably.
Now we mentioned Scott, we mentioned
Ida Lien, we felt she was really pushing above the weight on the tracks, we saw her missing targets, and what has come from those missed targets? She's been around the penalty loop. And Team Norway are 59 seconds, nearly a minute behind.
And that is a lot of work for Reuschlund and Tandreville to try and pull back.
It's a tall order, and I don't think it's possible. I think it's too much and not enough time to achieve it.
I'd say we've still got the stand shoot on this leg, but Ida Lien, where her mind will be in turmoil now, without a doubt.
Видим, как Вирр обходит ходом австрийку.
You don't normally expect it. There's not a howling gale out there. Quite a stable
и
day.
Там...
And as I say, I think mentally.
Анна Магнусен видно на горизонте, которую сильно оторвалась от чешки.
Stand position and still make it come through. Magnussen.
На отметке 8.7 у них было.
6 секунд разрыв.
Джессика Ислова.
Look at the separation of teams really beginning to open up these gaps.
Чехия.
Ислова looking good for the Czech Republic.
Chevalier Boucher, just now the light bulb moment. She'll be able to think. She'll start thinking about the shooting. And what process she's going to take when she gets on the mat.
Do you know what, Scott? I'm looking back. It's been 8 years since the French team won a relay here at this location. They have had a second place in between time, but not much more. We haven't had relays every season that we come here. But, yeah, it's a long time. Since 2016, when they last took the victory here.
Ну, канадка пока не справляется с таким уровнем, потихонечку отдает. Уже 18 секунд у нее. Самое главное, чтобы она справилась на огневом рубеже, без промахов.
We could expect to see another clean shoot.
Well, Jean-Paul,
Chevalier Boucher,
looking confident. Let's just say confident. Absolutely no wind on the range. Chevalier Boucher, her second time in, her final time in, before she skis a final 2 kilometers and hands over to her younger sister.
One breath between each shot.
Пять из пяти просто закрывает спокойно. С одним промахом едет на последний круг француженка. Один промах за две стрельбы.
Канадка.
Попадает канадка первая. Вирр вслед за ней. И Анна Гандлер из Австрии.
Магнусен
тоже 5 из 5 закрывает и будет вслед за немкой Софией Шнайдер. Борьба.
Hopefully the negative thoughts that went through her mind after going around the penalty loop aren't going to distract her. First two targets are down.
Джессика Ислова тут.
You know, when you push that hard,
а вот Ида Лен не справляется с ходом. У нее перед огневым рубежом было минута
22 отставания.
Закрывает.
Great for Ida Lien there, managing to get that target down. It is an achievement in and of itself to be on the Norwegian team. And when you're there, the last thing you want is for it to go wrong.
Yes,
ну, не знаю, если на предыдущих этапах Ройсланд хорошо себя показала, то вот Тандервольд, которая в спринте была лишь 52-й, но в гонке преследования она отыграла несколько позиций и была лишь 38-й. Тем самым она выпала из мирового рейтинга. С пятой позиции она сейчас Тандервольд, лишь девятая.
Well, those were the two rather wild shots from Sophia Schneider, physically under pressure coming in, and it didn't pay off in terms of her stand shooting. Good lead now for France. 30 seconds is a very comfortable lead at this. Well, coming up to halfway in the race, that's a huge lead. And last weekend, actually, in Germany, the French team finished sixth. So a much better relay race today. It's not over yet. So much can change when it comes to the relay.
Absolutely. And we've got Chloe Chevalier getting handed over to a third
leg. Мы видим тоже проигрывает ходом. Француженка просто очень хорошо идет.
So another one, great form, and a formidable team. It's going to be hard to beat the French today.
That was, you mentioned that result on day one of racing here from Chloe Chevalier. Previously, she'd never had bettered herself, never bettered position eight, which she had achieved five times in World Cup racing. That was the best in her career. And she looked so comfortable finishing in
second. Блин, такое ощущение, как будто зрители вниз движутся.
Yes, very much,
а мы просто идем вместе с биатлонисткой на одном уровне. Классный кадр.
And Dorothy Vera not getting that extra time of the cheering. Perhaps that would have made the difference and the results would have been actually a first place for
это на дроне они снимают.
Dorothy Vera, she was in fifth coming into the stand shoot. Now she's just moving into second place. What an athlete. And I think that... and this actually, when the Olympic Games come to Italy in 3 years' time, this is the venue, the home village of Dorothy Vera. Yes, she's 32-year-old now, but I think and I hope she'll remain in the team through to the Olympic Games, at least.
Sophia Schneider there, managing to keep with Dorothy Vera. It's not far to go, so all she has to do is hang on, but...
видимо, австрийка уже обогнала канадку, и шведка тоже ее обойдет.
Но
все равно для сборной Канады отличный пока результат. Пятая идет канадка.
Only four targets, spare rounds used for Sweden, so it's the ski speed that's lacking.
And Hanna Öberg getting handed over to for the Swedish team. So I think, like I said at the beginning, I think that we're going to see good things from Hanna today, and that's going to continue on for the world champs.
It's a big task, though. When you're now 46, it'll be more, maybe 50 seconds for Sweden when Magnussen comes in to hand over. It's a big task. I know the Öberg sisters are brilliant, but that is a big journey to take them back where they want to be at the top of the field.
Ну, отличный этап, я считаю, все равно для Софии Шнайдер. Она пока идет третий. Три промаха, но удерживает позицию для будущих этапов. Жаль, что отсутствует Денис Херман, которая финишировала бы отлично. У них Кибингер Ханна поедет. Но сейчас младшая сестра Хлоя Шолье.
Let's hope that's not at the back of her mind or at the fore of her mind as she comes in to shoot.
And Sophia Schneider there, gasping for air. You can see the pain written across her face.
Италии поедет Аушен Талер. Молодая, 21 год.
Dorothy Vera, brilliant performance, really.
Итальянка.
Surprising mistakes in prone shooting, but she made up for it when it came to standing and handing over in second place for Italy. This is a brilliant day for Italy, and it's the least experienced Hanna.
Ну, а у Германии Хеттич, которая хорошо показала в спринте, была седьмой. Видим Ханну Оберг в Швеции.
Relay team.
Hanna Öberg went off like a rocket for Sweden, but 49, we thought it might be around 50 seconds. Canada still there, well done, Canada.
Мы видели, что вчера Ханна Оберг очень хорошо шла ходом. Догнала даже свою младшую сестру. Но норвежцы передают эстафету, и тут у нас на третьем этапе Марта Ольсбю-Ройсланд.
No negative thoughts in her mind. I'm not going to try. None of
Чехия,
that.
It will be. I am on the hunt,
and I'm going to do the very best performance Davidova. I can on the assumption that anything is possible. This is biathlon.
Well, I tell you what is what may be possible. They're 1:22 behind, 1 minute 22 seconds behind, and that is a big, tall task for Reuschland and then Tanderold. But we are still only halfway. A lot can change, and the French team with Chloe Chevalier, you would expect a safe set of skis and hands on the range, and we'll have to wait and see.
And if 122 can be lost in the first two legs, it can also be gained in the last two legs. So
in the first World Cup, and then ninth at home in Hochfilzen, ninth in Ruhpolding last week, so very much improved day to day in Italy. And a very much improving team. So coming up to the high point on the first rotation of three for... her races. She's being very economical on the first lap. The second lap she opens up a little more, and she saves.
Проблемы сейчас стараюсь починить.
Expressionless, but I'm quite sure he'll be feeling very proud today that France is 37.
Извиняюсь за такую перебивку, к сожалению. Проблемы с интернетом.
Long hold of the breath before she squeezes the trigger, less so for the second shot. Edge, low left.
Ну, Хлоя Шевалье показывает. 5 из 5. Ждем преследователей.
Great that the shots went down and a confidence builder for the stand to come.
So, Chloe Chevalier, very comfortable there. I had some concerns and yes, holding the for that first shot, it can often be harmful, but she managed to get all 5 out of 5. Those chasing need the same. Germany, Italy, Sweden, and Austria. First miss for Germany. Italy, good news for Okuntala. Her father watching, he coaches the American team. Italy doing a grand
Hanover job. Hanover four. Sweden, итальянка попадает, молодая итальянка.
Well and truly
молодец.
Now into second place.
Not a single miss from the Austrian team so far, collectively, of all their athletes, so they
будут
go clear.
Преследовать.
Hannah Oeber goes clear.
Лидеры.
Well, that was under great pressure there for the 21-year-old just coming past her camera now. Okuntala, Italy, into second place. I think that Hannah Oeber coming out now, 44 behind. I think she may catch Okuntala on this lap of 2 kilometers. And Juppe still in there.
Austria, Anna Juppe едет прямо с кубка IBU. Показывает неплохие результаты, попадает в тридцатку. Ну а Ройсланд 5 из 5 и отыгрывает время потихонечку. Ройсланд. А вот Маркета Давыдова что-то не справляется со стрельбой.
That was spectacular, wasn't it? She was holding, I think, back a little on the track. And look at Davidova, still in the range.
Davidova.
Bullet left. She's got it down.
Да.
So Czech Republic survived in eighth place. And
Ройсланд,
well, she hasn't made anything. Ройсланд,
да, отыграла всего 4 секунды.
I would say that, but also her pacing. I think that she's gone slowly on lap one, and that's going to allow her to open up on two and three.
Там подошли украинки и швейцарки. Буду держать в курсе. У Украины Алена Белосюк, а у Швейцарии Лия Мейер.
But fearless to attack the target so quickly as a 21-year-old. Under huge pressure actually for the Italian team today. But they have momentum, they have success, and still to come. It's Lisa Vitozzi on the anchor leg. Still that little issue of stand shoot coming up. Thought maybe that Hannah Oberg would haul in the Italian team, and with her she's dragging the other nations.
It's great to see. Austria is still very much featuring, and Jupp there
Да, Анна Юпи очень хорошо держится. Даже отыгрывает понемножку у француженки. 2 секунды. Very effective in cross-country skiing in biathlon as it is in cycling,
just not quite as effective. Yes, certainly down the big descent. So this is pie for now for Canada. 1:12 behind, but the shooting has been very, very good today. Just 2 spare rounds required for the Canadian team, and a very much improved team actually into 6th place.
Again, no change in the time behind for Marta Olsbu Roysland.
Норвегия, минута 22, также 7 идет. Норвежка. А Украина на огневом рубеже попала, без промахов. 9-я Украина. Швейцария тоже без промахов. 11-е, 2:30 у Швейцарии отставание. А Эстонию, сборную Эстонию сняли, как круговую. У них было 4 штрафных круга и еще 11 дополнительных патронов использованы.
Ханна Урберг, you mentioned she's coming very much into form prior to the World Championships, and they're opting out to try and stay with this pace.
And I think sensibly, because the stand shoot we've seen already.
Видим, как Ханна Урберг просто отрывается от группы преследования.
Ханна Урберг.
Well, you said take it easier, but this lady is absolutely attacking Chloe Chevalier. That was a real punch up the
last of the big rises. Сборная Китая в чате. Хорошая. Осуждаю. And then up into the slightly uphill section into the range. There's your recovery. Метка 15.7. And it doesn't buy you much time. Ханна Урберг было 42 секунды отставания.
Get your breathing under control. Steve Klein here, and then a gentle incline as you pass.
Сейчас 34.7. Отыгрывает она 8 секунд. Ну и все остальные, Германия, Австрия, все отыгрывают потихонечку, по 4, по 5 секунд. Даже итальянка отыграла у Шевалье 2 секунды. А тут у нас 6-й огневой рубеж.
Swinging the hand round, so clearly the right hand, the trigger finger, not feeling overly warm. Is that a concern? We'll have to wait and see. No wind effectively to move the rifle. 5 shots standing.
10 breaths from the point of standing on the mat. She's taken a few more there. She wasn't quite ready.
I'm holding my breath.
Big pressure.
Very good. И попадает 10 из 10. Хлоя Шевалье просто Жан-Моно там улыбается, довольная, чай попивает. Класс, класс. Но осталось Жюли Симон лишь удержать такое огромное преимущество. 36 секунд до Ханны Урберг было перед рубежом. Attacking on the range and it's working. Oh, there's wobble. Yes, Уолберг стреляет как из пулемета и безошибочно.
Schneider missing the first, that's a setback, and Dana Jupp.
Итальянка может. Три раза.
Oh, real shame now, this turmoil going on.
А Шнайдер уходит, София.
Anna Ukenthaler, her brain will be.
You can see the wobble at the end of Ockenthaler's rifle as well. If you look closely and compare it to the boards behind,
тоже мажет второй.
She's a bit flustered. Yep, getting that round in wasn't easy.
Зато посмотрите, кто там сзади стоит. Марта Ольсбу Ройсланд просто как из пулемета выстреливает 5 из 5. Просто невероятная форма. Подводится она под чемпионат мира через 2.5 недели. Посмотрим, как она покажет на главном, так сказать, старте года.
Going on second leg,
на седьмом этапе Кубка мира. Минута 0.6 уже. Было минута 19, напомню.
Здесь
итальянка, которая
a little bit detrimental to the performance as well. You want to not be confident
about the
outcome, but be confident about the process. Why did he get the five?
Ну, молодая еще, 21 год.
Окенталер was in the hunt for the medals. Now sixth position, 134. Canada still way above expectations.
Запасных патрона потратил.
And a brilliant job there for Canada, still in seventh place. There's Jean Monod. Yep, I'm impressed. Happy with that. Glass of water in her hand, just enjoying the magnificent shooting from Chloe Chevalier. Well, the Swedish fans there, Scott, it's been well worth their journey from a long way away up
down here
to this beautiful Italian valley.
I think they must have heard that Hannah Öberg is coming into form.
Где же она?
Handing over to her sister, who, yeah, we like we said, she had a very unusual zero. It wasn't a strong zero. So one shot going top right, the next shot going at the very bottom of the prone ring. So she'll be, yeah, she's looking dynamic though, really getting the compression.
Отметку 16.7 прошли девушки, и Ханна Оберг также держится на 27 секундах отставания.
Well, I think that as she exited the range, Hannah Öberg was 27.5 behind. Yeah, still the first part of the course, she was still 27. I think she'll pull back time on Chloe Chevalier on this section. So Hannah Öberg at 27 behind.
Сборная Украины, девятые сейчас идут, вслед за Чехией. Швейцария, десятая. Сборная Словении, кстати. Не мажет, так сказать, без лампич в команде. Всего 6 дополнительных патрон за 3 этапа. 13-е, словенки.
Well, still at 27.5 behind, so we're not making that much improvement at all. So the middle lap of 2 kilometers, clearly Hannah Öberg taking herself to the limit. So Hettich Waltz, Germany still looking comfortable in third place, but they don't have Hermann taking the anchor leg as so normally, so often she does, resting today. So slightly weaker team, Hannah Kebinger has that responsibility today. Very much good results here from 19th to 10th yesterday, but very light in terms of World Cup racing. I think this is her sixth start today in World Cup racing.
Yeah, and actually she's done a lot of relays in World Cup. She's brought in for the purpose. She was
16.5.
The Olympic Winter Games.
Отыграла 11 секунд Ханна Оберг за километр.
So she's been on and off the relay events for the German team.
Well, Ханна Оберг really is. It was running at 27.5. Incredibly, Hannah.
Тут немка тоже очень быстро идет. 8 секунд отыгрывает. Это Хеттич. Ошибся.
33.4 for Germany.
Ну, очень хороший этап для нее.
Hettich
она и в спринте была седьмой.
Really,
ну и показывает нам Жюли Симон. Мне кажется, она не отпустит тут. Хотя мы видим, что Ханна Оберг уже на рубеже. Ой, уже на стадионе, а тут, смотрите, Эльвира выходит на свой четвертый этап. А тут сниму, да, как круговых сейчас? Да, снимает сборную Болгарии.
Incredibly back in the races. Hannah Öberg handing over to Elvira Öberg.
Ну а тут у Германии непривычный четвертый этап. Тут Ханна Кебингер.
But if I was Julia Simon, there'd be one person that I would not want to be on my tail, and that is Elvira Öberg.
Отличная этап от нее. Четвертый в стрике.
Which is a very small margin at this point. So
вслед за ней Марта Ольсбу-Ройсланд и Тандервольд на четвертом этапе. В Австрии, напомню, да, нету сегодня Лизы Трезехаузер, а вот жаль на самом деле. Жюлия Швайгер будет завершать гонку.
Very sparky, very dynamic. So great to see that Tangerwold is attacking this with the same sort of meaning and passion she's been performing so well with throughout the early season.
Very much. Here comes Okuntala. Now she'll need a little comfort after this because...
Смотрим на Италию. Лиза Витоцци очень хорошо показала, и вчера она была второй. К сожалению, один штрафной круг у Италии, и на шестую строчку они упали. Дальше покажут нам, там Маркета Давыдова завершает этап. Нет.
In Ruhpolding, third in the relay in Hochfilzen. So yeah, let's see if they can improve.
Маркета Давыдова передает эстафету Люси Шарватовой, Чехии. И Канада вслед за ними на восьмой позиции сейчас Канада.
The targets that Julia Simon missed yesterday, and she missed three and then two, so only 50% hit rate in prone shooting.
В сборной Канады всего за три этапа три дополнительных патрона использовано. Очень хорошо стреляют канадки и на высокой позиции держатся. Там также передает эстафету сборной Украины на девятой строчке. И сборная Швейцарии. Там Лена Хекке на четвертом этапе поедет. 2.49 отставание у швейцарок. А у сборной Украины Анастасия Меркушина будет заканчивать гонку. Показывает нам Эльвиру Оберг. Она немножко проиграла одну секунду.
So Elvira Uberg,
за 700 метров у Жюли Симон. Не в лучшей форме сейчас Эльвира. Она болела на прошлой неделе, пропустила два этапа. Эстафету как раз пропустила, где Швеция была не очень, так сказать. Не попали они в призы.
She has not got much experience on the World Cup. Yes, that's a worry, a slight concern for the German team. And I think that
Эльвира была два раза третьей. Даже с таким не лучшим ходом.
And Vitozzi will be getting a lot of positive information as she skis around this track.
Elvira Uberg really working hard to close the gap.
Километр, и Эльвира проиграла еще одну секунду у Жюли Симон. Но мы знаем, что Эльвира подняла сейчас стрельбу, и только вдумайтесь, если в прошлом году ее средний процент попаданий был 84, то сейчас 92%. Даже у Жюли Симон меньше, хотя еще если учитывать вчерашнюю гонку, где Жюли Симон сколько, 7 промахов совершила, то да. Ну вот и Жюли Симон на первом огневом рубеже. Посмотрим, как она справилась, поработала над ошибками. Вчера, напомню, на лёжке у неё было 5 промахов из 10. Всё, отлично. 5 из 5.
Absolute control. A lot of movement in the rifle, but that's her breathing in out, in out. I like that routine.
Really deep breaths, and that's so important. The oxygen is very much necessary. Two go down so far for Elvira Urban.
She needs 5 out of 5 to remain in the hunt for the first position.
Эльвира, отлично, отлично.
Shooting from Elvira Urban. She's off.
Big moment for Kebinger. She's not a regular in the relay team. She's been back at IBU Cup. Certainly looks great in the previous two days of racing here.
100% hit rate in prone so far of the two races.
Но тут Тандервольд.
So many of the spectators have just come across. It's only a 3-hour drive, 3.5-hour drive from Ruhpolding. She's
Германии два промаха.
and now under pressure with Tandrevold alongside her and also Schneider.
Will this be a redemption story for Tandrevold after a few dodgy races by her standards? Three go down.
Schweiger shooting really comfortably.
Тандервольд попадает в 5 из 5. Третий будет.
For Schweiger. The trio can work together, leaving Lisa Vitozzi, no matter what the outcome. She'll be in no man's land, fighting by herself. Now, Tandrevold's going to want to be on the hunt. She isn't going to want to lead, but it's necessary because she is the skier among the trio who is capable of closing the gap down on the podium.
So, Vitozzi. This is exactly what she wants. It's the damage limitation.
Beautiful 5 out of 5.
So good, such a high level, and absolutely fantastic for Vitozzi. She's capable of
beating those guys down easily.
When it goes wrong, it's just like there's a switch in her mind, and she can't. I can't explain it. Doesn't seem like there's too great an explanation. She comes out.
Бороться, если только за третью строчку. Минута 37.
Significantly, though, she's massively reduced the time deficit to it was a minute to third place. Now it's only what? It's at 31 seconds to third place. Mission accomplished after prone shooting.
Interesting to see low shot there from Julia Simon.
Сборная Канады там обходит чехов, идут, так сказать, секунда в секунду. Канадка седьмая, чешка восьмая. А у нас уже очень много команд сняли как круговых. Сборную Латвии, сборную Румынии, Польши, Словакии и да, Словения последняя. 13-я и остается в борьбе.
Big moment now coming into the final shoot of this race, the stand. So much can change, and it's all to play for the third position. Tangible there, still leading quite a heavy pace as they're, she's hunting down Uberg, who's 50 seconds ahead.
So Julia Schweiger there, just becoming detached, and that's annoying. When that little thread snaps, it becomes such a more difficult journey for Austria, but outperforming the ranking, fifth in
все идут the moment, в одном темпе. Время ни у кого практически не поменялось после стрельбы.
Place, but you know what? I feel there's less pressure here, but it is a huge margin, and she's only now relying on mistakes from all three ahead of her.
And the points are very important as well. This is three races so far, relay races of five races that contribute to the overall relay. Scores. So every single position is important, and with Sweden having finished seventh in the last race,
показывают нам режиссера.
Absolutely vital that they
20 секунд отставания.
Yes, and the World Championships for the first time isn't counting in terms of Nation Cup points, in terms of the relay. So there's only one relay remaining for the rest of the season, and that's on the 11th of March in Östersund in Sweden.
Ну а гонка уже перевалилась за один час.
So this is the trio battling up the hill. Skate 2, as you can see from Schweiger on the right hand side there of your screen.
Just as they
кто там гараж на Симон поставил? Отзовитесь в чате.
From Ukraine, the fastest, as so often is the case. Her younger sister is 10 years younger. They share the same birthday. Great to see her at the World Cup racing as well. She did well in the sprint race. And Ukraine still in 10th place. Just behind Switzerland.
Тандервольд отдает позицию немке.
Czech Republic 7th. And Vitozzi, of course, we've seen this chase. Vitozzi is next.
Ну и обходит ее.
So France ahead, 3 chasing. Tandervolt's in there, Kebinger. I should say the three chasing and Austria, but of course
ну
we have
Julie Simon на последнем огневом рубеже.
Jean-Paul expressionless, just checking the wind flags and just checking that Sweden are not coming in.
Да, ветра показывают, что нет. Ну и смотрим за лидером мировым. Кто там? Как кругового сейчас снимут?
Controlled pressure shot.
Ой-ой-ой, как же хорошо она стреляет. Просто невероятно. Что сказать, на данный момент топ-1 в мире. Эльвира Оберг мажет.
She needs to be careful. She knows that there's three athletes soon to come in alongside her. Two perfect prone hits.
Попадает на тоненьком прям. Смотрим. So three spare rounds, one left. Промахивается. Второй дополнительный. Там уже преследователи подходят. Еще один.
Last chance cafe. She's got to get this. She'll be able to hear her competitors get on the mat.
Попадает.
Yep. The target goes down. A lot of pressure there for Elvira. Just keeping us on the edge of our seats. But she's safely away.
Надеемся.
For second place.
На второе место.
Мажет Андроль.
Два. Три. Вот Андроль.
That's a mess. Germany. After missing the first, the next four go down.
Германия один остается.
Missing three out of the five. I beg your pardon, of course, it's Tandrevold, and we did question, is it wise Tandrevold on the last leg? It's not looking
like
it's paying off. Norway,
как? Германия сегодня будет третьей по ходу. Лиза Витоци, ладно, будет бороться все-таки.
Having lost the feeling at this World Cup, has lost it again on day three of racing. And that's a real surprise.
Ну а Тандервольд уходит на два штрафных. Здесь сегодня блестки не помогли сборной Норвегии. Талисман не сработал. Три штрафных за четыре этапа слишком много.
Витоци is very much in the hunt, but it's about a ski race now. She couldn't have done much better in terms of her shooting. And at the front, under a lot of pressure there. Julia Simon once again showing why she is the best in the world this season. So very safe at the front, almost by a minute, by the impeccable shooting, and Elvira Oberg having to use all three of her spare rounds to get the one shot that she missed. Here she is, losing a lot of time.
Показали Тандервольд. Шестая.
They would have hoped to her, but the race is very much on for the third place, I think, Scott. Schweiger, we've got Vitozzi 135 behind. Norway are now out of the podium.
So Vitozzi 135. Лена Хекке. Один промах всего. На восьмом огневом, и она седьмая. За ней, если за ней канадка едет. 3.11 у Канады отставание. Витоци отрабатывает сколько? 10 секунд. 11 даже. Напомню, было 9 после огневого рубежа. Давайте чат. Догонит Витоци. Сможет ли Витоци догнать немку или нет?
As opposed to allowing it to close. So great skiing from the German. Well done, Kebinger. And you know what? She may well have
2 km 300 m и 11 секунд отставания.
Just the elbow. Let's have a look.
Oof, что?
You can see the finger just skip the material of the clothing. So it's definitely.
Было бы смешно, если бы не попало.
I'm pleased we saw that because it's been in. I've been looking for on my phone for any info if that was a DQ, but no, clearly we would have seen that beforehand. Amazing. Now you do always.
Осматривается же Симон. А уже радуется все. Ну победа, да.
Penalty that somebody wasn't aware about and you weren't fighting all the way to the line. That would be a plot twist that you would not want to incur as you think you've won the race. Certainly not. Well, here we are, second place. So France, very comfortable. 53 ahead, and look at this.
Показывает нам отрыв.
So hard from the range, but I think that Vitozzi, and we can see further down the hill, she really is running out of time here to close the German.
Ждем отметку. 23.7.
third positions in the relay competitions this year.
Отметка 23.7 и 300 метров до финиша.
That's a world of pain and tension there going through Kipinger's legs. Yes, she's attacked so far from the range that we are running out of space for Vitozzi to make a
Vitozzi очень хороша ходом, мы это помним.
The attacks there, but we really are running out of time. But I think a great performance from Vitozzi. She did nothing wrong. And just the track, if it were another 500 meters, maybe she could close it down. It's all about France. They haven't had a victory
ну
here.
Ну и Франция завершает гонку. Жюли Симон,
Шевалье,
Шевалье Буше и Лоран Мано.
Jean Mono, Chevalier Boucher, her younger sister, Chloe Chevalier, and Julia Simon. Will that be the sequence and the team?
Сборная Швеции сегодня.
It's a strong team, no weak legs. Everyone in there has been on podium or is strong athletes, and I think that consistency is really what really.
Дополнительных патронов использовала Швеция против двух у Франции.
Weak leg, less strong leg is probably a more correct way of framing it.
So Sweden coming in, they've had a first, they've had a second, they were seventh last weekend. Today they're back on the podium.
Сколько? 7 секунд было на отметке 23.7 между немкой и итальянкой.
Today the second place takes them comfortably and separated by many more points at the top.
Нет, все уже.
Kipinger has probably bought herself a ticket to the World Championships, and I think she certainly has the way she's been racing this weekend. Vitozzi really did try. She put everything on out of the tracks there, but
конец гонки от немки и Денис Херман. Не понадобилось команде.
Отлично, отлично. She is ecstatic. Well done, Germany. They are the team who've won most relays here. Give her some air. She needs air badly, and what a great job to hang on to third place. Vitozzi, she had to come back from a long way.
Сборную Словении сняли, как круговых, и сборную США. Словенка, которая уже отстрелялась, причем отстрелялась на ноль. Всего 6 дополнительных у них было, у Словении, и их сняли как круговых. Все-таки, когда они промахивались, Слампич в команде, они завершали гонку, а тут... Чуть-чуть не хватило им.
Speed as well as accuracy today. They were managed to. They're the third fastest shooting team.
Вот еле-еле дышит, задыхается немка. А тут Тандроль. Сегодня шестая сборная Норвегии.
France have only used two spare rounds. Austria three spare rounds. Now Norway, the big name of Norway, will be asking some questions. It's easy to review things in hindsight. I did wonder when I saw it last night, Tandrevold, and she didn't look confident. We mentioned that at the start of the program. She didn't look confident on the range when it came to zeroing, and I really feel for Tandrevold. She'll take this personally. It was a real opportunity for third place. And
а тут Лена Хеке, седьмое место.
В Швейцарии.
Ну, боец, обогнала она канадку, да, канадке было трудно с ней бороться, очень много отыграла, около 30 секунд она отыграла.
Switzerland, well, you were right. I felt they could make a top five today, but at the moment, seventh place for Switzerland. Heike Gross, married this summer. Two good races, actually. 24.
Канадка тут за восьмую строчку борется. Украина потом догоняет, девятая.
And what a fabulous day for Canada.
Dixon did a really good game. I think they were doing fantastic at the beginning. Great shooting from the whole team, and then.
Мужская эстафета будет. Вслед за женской через час где-то. В описании там есть ссылка на канал, на другой. Переходите, там будет трансляция мужской эстафеты.
Чешки,
лишь десятые, Очень много ошибок было у Маркеты Давыдовой. 6 дополнительных патронов. И на четвертом этапе тоже чешка не справилась. 3 дополнительных на первом огневом рубеже и 2 штрафных круга на втором. С 3 дополнительными. Ну и последнюю сборную мы встречаем. 11 сборных всего закончило сегодня гонку. Финляндия. Да, всем спасибо за просмотр. Сейчас награждение. Не знаю, оставить да, награждение или нет.
Eine schwierige Situation. Wenn wir Meister wurde.
Кто это муж Ройсланд, да, обнимает своих подопечных.
Julia, what a way to put maybe not the best weekend behind, but a fantastic team performance, and you really put it home.
Yeah, really happy with this performance today. Biathlon is never easy. It was a bit of individual races for me, and it was really important today to shoot good and have a good race before leaving home. But yeah, today we did a really good job, all the team. I think it's our record because it's only two spare, and it was it's the first time, I think. And yeah, really happy.
Quite a close changeover.
Yeah, for me, no, because I know that Chloe touched me just here. So yeah, it was okay for me, but yeah, I saw the screen on the last lap, and I say, why? No, there is no problem. But yeah, I think it was more stressful for the staff and the girl here than for me during the race. So yeah, happy end.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Отлично, уезжает домой Жюли Симон отдыхать. На вторую строчку попадают сборная Франции. Выключил музыку там, которая играет на стадионе, чтобы не заблокировали за авторские права. Но мы ждем награждения. Еще раз напомню, что на 2,5 недели уходит биатлон с больших экранов. Сейчас отдых, и 8 декабря в Германии стартует 7-й этап и Кубок мира. Взяли за руку. Это ведь медведи, чат. Поправьте меня, если я не прав. В Италии кто национальный герой? Навряд ли медведь. Да, Германию поддерживают на трибунах. И на самом деле с таким составом не сказать бы, что они победят, допустим, ту же Норвегию. Но они здесь третьи сегодня. Натали Санта from the IBU Executive Board and Mr. Philip Ahama, representative of the government of South Tyrol. Лимперсон недовольна все равно, видимо, своей ездой. Ну вот и чемпионы. Шевалье Буше там плачет от счастья. Что, ждем фото отдельно? Да, у шведок. Да, всем спасибо. Заканчиваем. Уходим на перерыв, так сказать. Но мы все так же любим биатлон. Переходите по ссылке в описании. Там есть канал в описании. Другой. Там сегодня будет показывать эстафету мужскую. У Хлои Шевалье такая красивая улыбка. Всем спасибо.